Hello, everyone. It's so great to be with you today for this important Retirement Security Symposium. And for those of you joining in person, it's good to have you here in the House of Labor. These conferences play such a critical role in helping us to share information and talk with each other about the issues that shape our work in this important moment in our movement. So I hope that you're all looking forward to an engaging and productive day. I want to start by thanking a few people who made today possible. ARA President Robert Roach, Secretary Treasurer Joe Peters, and Executive Director Rich Fiesta, and of course your EVPs, Julie Horwin, and the AFL-CIO's incredible Secretary Treasurer, my partner Fred Redmond. Thank you for not only bringing us together today, but for building such a powerful community and resource for retired workers. You understand that workers' connection to the labor movement doesn't end when you clock out for the last time. And you understand that the labor movement's responsibilities to workers don't end then either. I remember when we started the AFL-CIO Retirement Security Working Group and getting it all set up with all the union leaders and advocates, partners and experts, building on the phenomenal groundwork laid over many years. And it's incredible to see how far we've come and what we've been able to accomplish. Nowhere was the ARA and the Retirement Security Working Group's impact more evident than in the incredible advocacy we did together for retirees as the American Rescue Plan was coming together. When we head to Capitol Hill to negotiate and advocate, and labor's voice is unified on multi-employer pension relief, we are powerful. Now, we had our moments of disagreement, but we were steadfast in our principles and never once allowed retired workers to be left out of the conversation. And I know from experience how difficult it can be to have all those powerful people in one room and get to one plan, but that's exactly what we did. And it led to the Butch Lewis Emergency Pension Plan Relief Act becoming part of the American Rescue Plan. I can't think of a more fitting tribute to Butch, who was such a leader in the fight to save his fellow Teamsters' pensions. And I know Rita is joining us today, so Rita, I hope you know how much Butch meant to this movement and how proud we were to keep fighting in his honor. Thanks to the advocacy of the AFL-CIO, the ARA, and the Retirement Security Working Group, the American Rescue Plan delivered $86 billion in federal financial assistance to protect the retirement benefits of workers and retirees in financially troubled multi-employer pension plans. That money is intended to cover all benefits due for at least 30 years and comes without any of the onerous strings that were previously on the table. No union or employer fees, no benefit cuts, no requirement to pay back the money. That is an incredible achievement. And I think the reason this group was able to come together and unify like that is because protecting pensions is such a clear priority for all of us. The labor movement knows that pensions are more than just part of the retirement plans of millions of Americans. They are a promise employers make to their workers. And those promises should not be broken after years or decades of hard work. I know what that promise means. My dad worked at our local electric utility company in Portland, Oregon for nearly 40 years. And 1 year before he was going to retire, PGE was bought by Enron. And I'm sure people are familiar with this story, but they built a house of cards, lying and cheating investors. And it wasn't long before Enron went bankrupt. And the collateral damage was that working people like my dad, whose portfolio had a lot of Enron matching stock, lost their retirement security overnight. My family watched as his hard-earned pension went from dollars to dimes in the blink of an eye. We want to make sure that the next generation of workers don't face those same kind of challenges, that the promise of a pension is delivered to them. And that's why I'm excited to see that there are so many new efforts from the machinist to AFT, to include younger people in this work. And I know you'll hear more from them today about how we can better reach out to the next generation and get them even more involved. I'm confident that we'll all come out of this symposium with new ideas and renewed energy in our fight for retirement security. Your dedication and commitment to this work and to our movement are unparalleled. Thank you all for always being in the fight, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.